Dear students, welcome to our next lecture in quantum chemistry, that is basic postulates of quantum chemistry. We will deal with basic postulates of quantum chemistry. In last lecture, we had seen about the operators. The basic postulates are depending on this operator. So we have taken operators first and then we are going for the basic postulates of quantum chemistry. In operators, we had seen that what are operators, as well as we have seen the algebra of operators, where we had seen addition and subtraction, as well as we had seen also the multiplication of operators. Then we had seen about the commutative properties of operators, and we had seen the linear properties of operators, which operators can be called as linear operator, and which two operators or which set of operators can be called as commutative or non-commutative operators. Then and finally, we had seen about the eigenvalues and eigenfunctions. Eigenvalues and eigenfunctions are very important and they form one of the basic postulates of quantum chemistry. So we will revisit these things again in this lecture. So first, let us see the basic postulate number one. The postulate number one states that the state of a microsystem is described in terms of a function of position coordinates and time, called as a wave function. This we had seen it when we were dealing with Schrodinger's wave equation. Schrodinger's time independent wave equation jab humne derive kiya tha, tab bhi humne wave function ko define kiya tha, and that we had defined it that the wave function defines the state of a microsystem, which is in terms of position coordinates and time. So we had defined psi as a function of position coordinates and time, which we can write it as psi of rt or psi of xyz t. So it is a function of position coordinates xyz and time t. So this describes the state of a microsystem, state of the system or state of the particle which is under consideration. So ye wave function se hame mil sakta hai, sari information hame mil sakti hai. We can take every information needed from particle or from the system can be obtained from this wave function, can be obtained from this wave function psi, which is a function of position coordinates and time. So at a particular instant of time or at a particular position, what is the information that we need to take out from the system or from the microsystem, that can be easily be obtained from this. This is what our first postulate is. It defines a wave function which can be used to extract all the information that is needed for us. All experimentally observable informations can be easily obtained it from this wave function psi. Second postulate states that to an every observable quantity or every observable quantity or experimentally measurable quantity such as position, momentum or kinetic energy, there exists a corresponding quantum mechanical operator. Means ki jo bhi quantity agar hame chahiye ho, like for example, if we want to have a position of a certain particle at a given instant of time, or if you want to find out a momentum of a particle at a particular instant of time, if you want to find out kinetic energy or total energy or the potential energy, or total energy of the system, then for each of this we have different operators. These are physical quantities which are measurable physical quantities. So for each of these quantities we have an operator which we can use it on the wave function psi, such that it will give us this particular property. Agar hum position operator agar hum use karte hain wave function par, तो हमें पोजीशन मिलेगा. अगर हम काइनेटिक एनर्जी का ऑपरेटर यूज करते हैं तो हमें काइनेटिक एनर्जी मिलेगी. अगर हम पोटेंशियल एनर्जी का ऑपरेटर यूज करेंगे तो वी विल गेट द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी फ्रॉम दैट वेव फंक्शन. सो हियर फॉर एग्जांपल वी हैव द पोजिशन जो ऑपरेटर होता है दैट इज डिनोटेड बाय एक्स. द मोमेंटम ऑपरेटर कैन बी डिफाइंड एज एच अपॉन टू बाय आई इंटू डेल बाय डेल एक्स प्लस डेल बाय डेल वाई प्लस डेल बाय डेल जेड. That can be written as h upon 2 by I. This is nothing but del. So we can write it as here this operator. So this becomes an operator for momentum. अगर हम ये wave function पर apply करते हैं, तो हमें momentum मिलेगा. Like apply means like we have h upon 2 by I del of psi. अगर ये equation को हम solve करते हैं, तो हमें momentum of the operator, momentum of the particle मिल जाएगा यहाँ से. सिमिलरली काइनेटिक एनर्जी का जो ऑपरेटर होता है दैट इज माइनस एच स्क्वायर अपॉन एट पाई स्क्वायर आई और एट पाई स्क्वायर एम इनटू डेल स्क्वायर वेयर डेल स्क्वायर इज नथिंग बट लैप्लेशियन ऑपरेटर. सो फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन गेट इट द काइनेटिक एनर्जी. पोटेंशियल एनर्जी का ऑपरेटर इज वी. सिमिलरली टोटल एनर्जी का ऑपरेटर विल बी काइनेटिक एनर्जी प्लस पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. सो इट विल बी माइनस एच स्क्वायर अपॉन 8 pi square m into del square plus v. So this will be giving us the total energy operator, which is also called as a Hamiltonian operator. This we call it as a Hamiltonian operator. Remember this Hamiltonian operator. So this Hamiltonian operator gives us the total energy of the system or total energy of the particle. We have Schrodinger wave equation as h psi equals e psi. यहाँ पे h psi h is nothing but this Hamiltonian operator which operates on this wave function psi to give us same wave function in multiplied by total energy. Same wave function मिल रहा है means this is our eigen function from our previous lecture on operators. We had seen about what are eigen functions. So this psi becomes an eigen function with e as an eigen value. E becomes eigen value and this is our operator, Hamiltonian operator. ये हमारा Schrödinger wave equation हो गया. This is our short form of Schrödinger time independent wave equation. So this is our postulate number two. Now postulate number three suggests that the possible values of any physical quantity of a system such as energy, momentum, position, kinetic energy, etc. are given by eigenvalues in the eigenvalue equation. Eigenvalue equation हमने देखा था last lecture में operator A operating on f of x equals A into f of x. This becomes an eigenvalue equation. This is called as an eigenvalue equation. Where operator operates on a function to give back same function multiplied by a constant. This constant we call it as eigenvalue and this function we call it as eigen function. This function we call it as eigen function or ye jo constant usko multiplied hota hai that we call it as eigenvalue. What does postulate 3 suggest that the possible value of any physical quantity of a system is given by eigenvalues in the eigenvalue equation. Means कि अगर हम kinetic energy का operator operate करते हैं function पर, तो हमें जो eigenvalue मिलेगा, that eigenvalue will be the kinetic energy of the system. Kinetic energy of that particular system हमको eigenvalue से मिलेगा. जितनी भी eigenvalue आएगी, उतना आपका kinetic energy होगा. अगर operator kinetic energy का है, अगर operator momentum का होगा, तो eigenvalue हमें momentum मिलेगा. अगर ऑपरेटर हमारा पोजीशन का होगा तो हमें आइगन वैल्यू पोजीशन के कोऑर्डिनेट्स मिलेंगे वहां पर. सो व्हिच ऑपरेटर यू आर ऑपरेटिंग ऑन द फंक्शन ऑन द वेव फंक्शन दैट वैल्यू यू विल गेट इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ आइगन वैल्यूज. सो इट बिकम्स अ वेरी इजी इक्वेशन. आइगन वैल्यू इक्वेशन अगर हमको याद है ए ऑफ एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल्स ए ऑफ एफ ऑफ एक्स. ऑपरेटर ए ऑपरेटिंग ऑन एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल्स ए ऑफ एफ ऑफ एक्स. This will become an eigenvalue equation. इसमें हमें जो operator होगा हमारा वो हमारा यहाँ पे eigenvalue में उसकी value मिल जाएगी. Each single measurement of a physical quantity A gives an eigenvalue small a of the operator Also, the eigenvalues and eigenfunctions for a system can be obtained by solving the operator equation, that is solving the eigenvalue equations. If we are solving the eigenvalue equation, we will get back the eigenvalues or the physical quantity for that particular operator. So we can very easily have it operator A operating on f of x equals A into f of x. Ye equation aapko yaad rakhna hai. This equation we call it as eigenvalue equation. Jisme ye hamara eigenvalue hota hai. This is our eigenfunction. This is our operator. So ye agar teen cheeze hame yaad ho, तो हमें यहां से ऑपरेटर कौन सा हम यूज कर रहे हैं उसके ऊपर डिपेंड करेगा कि आइगन वैल्यू हमें क्या मिलेगी. वी हैव जस्ट सीन दैट दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑपरेटर्स. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस देयर आर लॉट ऑफ मेनी डिफरेंट ऑपरेटर्स वी कैन यूज इट. ये हमारे सिंपल ऑपरेटर्स थे, इनको यूज करके हम करस्पॉन्डिंग आइगन वैल्यूज निकाल सकते हैं फ्रॉम दिस आइगन वैल्यू इक्वेशन. सो दिस वॉज अवर पोस्टुलेट नंबर थ्री. पोस्टुलेट नंबर फोर सेज दैट द एवरेज वैल्यू or the expectation value of a physical quantity m of a system whose state function is psi can be given by the average value m bar can be given as integration of psi star operator m operating on psi d tau divided by integration of psi star psi d tau. So by this equation we can get the average value or the expectation values of the physical quantity. अगर हम कोई भी operator use करते हैं तो उस operator का जो average value होता है या expectation value जो होता है वो हमें इस particular equation से मिलता है. ऐसा this is our postulate number four. Now here we can write it in a simple way if psi is normalized. नॉर्मलाइजेशन क्या होगा इसके लिए हम एक अलग से लेक्चर लेंगे. नॉर्मलाइजेशन एज वेल एज ऑर्थोगोनालिटी एंड दिस नॉर्मलाइजेशन ऑर्थोगोनालिटी एंड ऑर्थो नॉर्मल फंक्शंस दिस थ्री थिंग्स वी विल टेक इट इन वन सिंगल लेक्चर लिटिल लेटर ऑन. That you can see it, what is normalization, what is orthogonality, and what functions we call it as orthonormal functions. Again, for a simple term, agar normalized wave function hoga, to integration of psi star psi d tau will be equal to 1. Agar ye equal to 1 hoga, then it is called as a normalized wave function. Agar ye equal to 0 hota, to we call it as an orthogonal function. If it is equal to 0, then we call it an orthogonal function. Agar ye equal to 1 hota hai, toh it is called as a normalized wave function. And if for say this I and J, do alag alag function ho agar, or agar dono alag alag functions hain, then it becomes 0. Agar dono same function ho, toh agar equal to 1 hota hai, then such set of functions we call it as orthonormal function. Jo ki aapas mein, they are orthogonal to each other, but each other they are normalized. They are normalized wave functions, but with each other they are orthogonal to each other. So such functions we call it as a orthonormal function. Now यहाँ पर अगर हम ये psi we call it as a normalized function. If psi is normalized, if psi is normalized, then denominator becomes 1. Psi star psi of d tau becomes 1. So we have m bar will be equal to integration of psi star m operator operating on psi d tau. So this will be our normal equation where m is an operator of m, where m cap is operator of quantity, physical quantity m. Now we can have two different cases for this. Case one, if psi is an eigenfunction, psi is an eigenfunction of operator n with eigenvalue. Agar wo eigenfunction hai, then it should give an eigenvalue and let that eigenvalue be smaller. such that integration of such that operator m operating on psi equals small m into psi. So अगर हम हमारा ये सिंपल केस है जहां पे psi is an eigen function for operator m, अगर ये चीज है तो हमारा इक्वेशन वन जो है that is this particular equation can be written as equation one becomes average value of m, m bar equals integration of psi star m cap psi d tau upon integration of psi star psi d tau. Here we know that m psi m cap psi is equal to m psi, so we can replace this by m psi, so we will have it integration of psi star m into psi d tau upon integration of psi star psi d tau. M यहाँ पे constant है because it is an eigen value, so eigen value is a constant, so ये हम integration के बाहर ले सकते हैं, so it will be m into integration of psi star psi d tau divided by integration of psi star psi d tau. So this numerator and denominator gets cancelled, so this becomes m. So our average value m will be equal to the eigen value. This means that the observable m has a precisely same value as the eigenvalue. That is, our average value or expectation value of that operator is the same as the eigenvalue. Agar hamara function eigen function hai to, agar eigen function hai to, just find out the eigenvalue and that will be equal to the observable value. Jo hamara yahan pe humne postulate 3 mein humne dekha tha. Operator A operating on f of x gives the eigen function back and the eigen value. So, ये eigen value is the measurement value or the value of the physical quantity. Possible value of any physical quantity is given by eigen values. So, ये हमारा eigen value हो गया. So, यहाँ पर भी हम वही कर रहे हैं कि अगर psi हमारा eigen function है, तो हमारा जो average value या expected value जो होगा, वो eigen value होगा उसका. लेकिन अगर साय हमारा आइगन फंक्शन नहीं है, देन व्हाट हैपेंस केस टू, इफ साय इज नॉट एन आइगन फंक्शन, इफ साय टू साय इज नॉट एन आइगन फंक्शन ऑफ ऑपरेटर एम, देन व्हाट हैपेंस, देन व्हाट वी कैन डू इज दैट इफ दिस इज नॉट एन आइगन फंक्शन, then we can imagine that M has a set of its own orthonormal eigenfunctions. It is a set of its own orthonormal eigenfunctions phi I. Then psi can be expressed as a1 phi 1 plus a2 phi 2 plus so on, such that psi equals summation over I of ai phi I, where I goes from 1 2 3 and so on. यहाँ पे हम क्या इमेजिन कर रहे हैं कि अगर साय हमारा आइगन फंक्शन नहीं है, देन वी कैन इमेजिन दैट एम हैज, कि एम के पास अपना एक ऐसे आइगन फंक्शन है जो कि ऑर्थोनॉर्मल है, इट्स दे आर ऑर्थोनॉर्मल टू ईच अदर, लेकिन हम इनको ऐसे एक्सप्रेस कर सकते हैं कि साय इज इक्वल टू समेशन ऑफ ऑल दोज फंक्शंस, दैट इज साय इज ए1 फाइव 1 प्लस ए2 फाइव 2 प्लस ए3 फाइव 3 एंड सो ऑन. ऑर्थोनॉर्मल का मतलब क्या होता है कि इफ यू हैव एन इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ से पाई वन पाई टू ओवर अ स्पेस से डीएक्स, इफ इट इज इक्वल टू वन, इफ एंड ओनली इफ 1 is equal to 2. That is, let's say here I and j. For simplicity, ये I है और ये j है, then this will be equal to 1 if and only if I is equal to j. That is, अगर ये integration of phi 1 of dx है, तो ये 1 होगा. Phi 2 होगा तो 2 तो भी 1 होगा. Phi 3 होगा तो भी 1 होगा. That is, it is normalized wave function. और बाकी सारे cases हैं. Where phi ij of dx will be equal to 0 if I is not equal to j. Means integration of phi 1, phi 2 of dx will be 0. Integration of phi 3, phi 5 is 0. Integration of phi 1, phi 3 will be 0. जहां कहीं भी I और j same नहीं है, वहां पे ये 0 होगा. और जहां कहीं भी I और j same होंगे, वहां पे ये equal to 1 होगा. ऐसा सेट ऑफ जो होता है, वो सेट को हम बोलते हैं ऑर्थोनॉर्मल सेट ऑफ फंक्शंस. ऐसे फंक्शंस के सेट को हम बोलते हैं ऑर्थोनॉर्मल सेट ऑफ फंक्शंस. सो हम यहां पे क्या अजम्पशन कर रहे हैं कि ऑपरेटर m हैज अ सेट ऑफ इट्स ओन ऑर्थोनॉर्मल आइगन फंक्शंस. ये सारे ही आइगन फंक्शंस हैं ऑपरेटर m के लिए, लेकिन ये सारे ही आपस में ऑर्थोनॉर्मल. So they must be orthonormal to each other and they should be eigenfunction to M also. Such that psi is equal to phi 1, A1 phi 1 plus A2 phi 2 plus A3 phi 3 and so on. So if such is the case, then what we can have is equation 1 hum yahan pe likh sakte hain if it is psi is normalized. If psi is normalized, then what happens is, कि अगर ये normalized है, तो ये जो denominator है equation 1 का, ये 1 हो जाएगा, so we will have this particular function, m bar equals integration of psi star m cap psi d tau. So ये अगर हम यहाँ पे use करते हैं, if psi is normalized, then m average will be equal to integration of psi star m cap psi d tau. इसको हम use कर सकते हैं, by psi हमारा क्या है, summation of ai fi. So we can have integration of summation of ai phi I over I of star m cap summation over j aj phi j theta. Such that now अगर ये हमारा normalized है, इसलिए यहाँ पे denominator हमने गायब कर दिया है, because it becomes 1. हमारा normalized wave function होगा, तो it will be equal to 1. So हमने वो denominator finish कर दिया. So now यहाँ पर हमारा क्या है? We have said that these are eigen functions. So these are eigen functions. Let eigen value be lambda I. Let eigen value be lambda I. So, यहाँ पर इसका जो eigen value होगा, operator m is operating on this function, so इसका जो lambda eigen values होंगे, that will be our lambda I. So, this will be equal to integration of summation ai phi I star or I lambda I into summation of aj yj for j d tau. So what we can say is that agar ye summation se, summation ka jo sign hai ye hum bahar nikalte hain integration se, aur lambda I hamara constant hai wo bhi hum bahar nikal sakte hain. So we can get this as summation over I into summation over j ai aj, that is AI star AJ integration of phi I lambda I phi J d tau. Now we know that this lambda I, or here it was J, so yahan pe hamara ye lambda J hoga. So this lambda J is nothing but an eigen is eigen value, so it will be constant. So ये constant को हम integration के बाहर ला सकते हैं. So what we can write is write over here is m bar will be equal to summation over I summation over j a I star a j lambda j integration of phi I star phi j theta. Now what we had said while assuming this that these are orthonormal sets. Orthonormal sets में जहां I और j equal होंगे वहां पे equal to 1 होगा, जहां I और j not equal होंगे वहां पे ये 0 हो जाएगा. So जब हम summations करेंगे इसका, तो जहां I और j same रहेंगे वहां पे 1, and जहां I और j same नहीं होंगे वहां पे वो 0 हो जाएगा. So what we can say is that since phi I are orthonormal, phi I are orthonormal, that is integration of phi I star phi j d tau will be equal to 0 for I not equal to j and equal to 1 for I equal to j. So this is our orthogonal condition. जो function orthogonal भी है और normalized भी है उनको हम बोलते हैं orthonormal. So it is a normalized and it is orthogonal also. Amongst itself it is normalized, with each other it is orthogonal. So अगर ये ऐसा होगा तो जहां ये सेम रहेंगे उनका ही सिर्फ ये summation होगा, बाकी सब में ये zero हो जाएंगे. So what we can have is m bar will be equal to summation of ai star ai, because j हमारा अगर सेम रहेगा तो ही ये बचेगा, अदरवाइज ये जीरो हो जाएगा. सो ai star ai lambda i, और वी कैन राइट इट सिंपली एज समेशन ऑफ ai square lambda i. समेशन ऑफ ai square lambda i. सो दिस इक्वेशन व्हाट डज इट सजेस्ट, दैट इट मींस दैट each measurement of m must give one of the eigenvalues lambda I and average of all of these values is m bar. So हम ये सारा सेट मिला करके हमारा लैम्ब्रा आई का हमें देता है, आइगन वैल्यूज हमें देता है, इनका सबका जो एवरेज होगा दैट एवरेज वी विल गेट इट एज m वैल्यू. ये कब होता है, जब साय हमारा आइगन फंक्शन नहीं होता. अगर साय हमारा आइगन फंक्शन है तो उसका जो आइगन वैल्यू होगा दैट विल बी योर वैल्यू, एवरेज वैल्यू या एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू फॉर द फंक्शन, फॉर द ऑपरेटर. जो भी हमें वैल्यू चाहिए था वो वहां से डायरेक्टली मिल जाएगा आइगन वैल्यू से. लेकिन अगर आइगन फंक्शन नहीं है तो फिर हमें ये एवरेज वैल्यूज यहाँ से निकालनी पड़ेगी, एंड देन वी विल गेट दैट पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू ओवर देयर. अगर लास्ट अजम्पशन लास्ट पोस्टुलेट फॉर द क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स इज that for every system, time-dependent Schrödinger wave equation exists. We have seen time-independent Schrödinger wave equation, but for every system, time-dependent Schrödinger wave equation also exists. It is time-dependent Schrödinger wave equation that also exists for every system. That is our postulate 5, and it is given by Hamiltonian operator operated on wave function psi equals I h cross upon 2 pi del psi by del t, or this can be written as I h cross, so this will be I h upon 2 by del psi by del t equals I h cross del psi by del t. So this is our time dependent Schrodinger wave equation, where h cap is Hamiltonian operator. Psi is acceptable wave function, which is dependent on position coordinates and time, and v is the potential energy which is present in the Hamiltonian operator, which is given by Hamiltonian operator as minus h square upon 8 pi square m del square plus v of x, y, z, where v of x, y, z is potential energy. Del square is Laplacian operator given by d square by dx square plus d square by dy square plus d square by dz square. So this is how we can give this time-dependent Schrodinger wave equation. This was postulate number 5. So we have seen all the 5 postulates of basic postulates of quantum mechanics. Thank you.